Hello everybody, this is Yoko's Anime Reactions, and this is going to be my review for Dragon Ball Z Kai episode, Dragon Ball Z Kai 2014 episode 7, I think? Let me look real quick. Anyway, I actually noticed a moment ago, or not really a moment ago, but earlier in the day when I was just going over my stuff, that of the four subscribers that I had gotten before when I went from 808 to 812, three subscribers subscribed on the searching Google and searching using the Google thing to search Dragon Ball characters video. So yeah, that's great. I'm surprised that they wanted to subscribe because of that video. I assume that's the case. If that's not the case, whoever ended up subscribing at that point, please let me know. You know, what ended up making you want to subscribe, because I'd love to know what gets people to want to subscribe to my channel. And if it's something that's still ongoing, then I'll obviously do more of it. Anyway, what was I gonna say? Essentially, this is the episode where the tournament pops up, essentially. Gohan and Goten end up finishing up their flying training for Videl, and she finally leaves, and the boys are finally able to get started on their training for the tournament. And obviously, Mr. Satan's not doing a gosh darn thing when it comes to training, because he essentially thinks that no one's going to be stronger than him, despite the fact that 7 years have passed. You would think that essentially you would do some training of your own, even a year's worth of training in that 7 year time difference would do some good, essentially. Because people can train all those 7 years and surpass you. And he didn't once think of that? I guess not. Anyway. Oh, I'm so sleepy. Oh my god. I want to take a nap so much, but I can't, because once again, I get saddled with watching my nephews. Again. Every day. I get up, take care of the kids, deal with them until my mom comes down, and even then, sometimes she just leaves the house and goes into town and does stuff. And I think today was to go to my not my biological cousin, because I'm not related to them at all. Or by blood is what I mean. Her bridal shower. And my mom said that she wasn't going to stay the whole 3 hours, because it's an open house type thing where you can come and go as you please. And it's already 12:30. I have to be at work at 3. This always happens, every time. I have to watch the kids until probably an hour, or even less than that, before I have to go into work, and then I don't get any time to myself because I have to work until I close, and when we close at 10, and I get home around 10:15, 10:30, and then I have to go to bed. So I get no time to myself because I have to keep an eye on the dang kids. And you would not believe what happened when I left the house yesterday morning to go to work. Apparently, the fridge door wasn't latched all the way, and when I say latched, we have childproof locks on the door, and my nephew has figured out how to lock the door, but when he went to lock it, I thought he had locked it all the way. Apparently, he didn't get it to click. So, my dad came into the store and told me that they had gotten into the fridge and gotten milk, buttermilk, and juice, and got it all over the floor, except the juice, because they couldn't get the juice open. So, yeah, it was the only reason that they were able to get into it is because my mom was not down here to watch the kids. I had told her, I have to get ready for work, you have to come downstairs. She did not come downstairs until my dad came inside. Because she apparently thought that my dad was home. What she needs to do from now on is automatically assume that my dad's not here. Until she's proven otherwise. In which case, then, if he is here, and he's willing to watch the kids, then she can go upstairs and go take a nap. But yeah, I figured she was getting ready to come downstairs. I was waiting for her to come down, and I had like 5 minutes before I had to be at work, and I was like, screw this. She's coming down. They'll be fine. Anyway, the day of the tournament comes, and everybody is excited, and they all made an agreement not to go Super Saiyan during their fights in order to essentially level the playing field, because otherwise it would just be no contest. It would only be a contest between the other Saiyans, essentially, because everybody else would be getting their butts kicked.
Anyway.
They get there, and obviously Mr. Satan and Videl make their entrance. Videl doesn't do anything flashy, just walks off the plane. But Mr. Satan obviously is just milking it and milking it. And obviously the only people who know what really happened at the Cell Games were the ones who were actually there. And, what I don't get is why Mr. Satan is even lying about this, because he knows the truth. He was there the whole time, and he knows he didn't do a gosh darn thing to take out Cell. So why lie about it? Everybody's gonna think he's a massive idiot and leave him, essentially, if they found out the truth. So, yeah, apparently this continues even to the end of Dragon Ball Z Kai, where they have the other tournament, where certain things are afoot, but I will not mention what they are, because that obviously takes place in Super. So, question, you guys. For you Dragon Ball fans out there, what episode should I stop watching Kai before it gets to that tournament, obviously, because then I'll have to pick up Super? So let me know which episode I need. Anyway, they're all looking around for Goku, and he uses instant transmission to teleport in, or Fortune Teller Baba could have just brought him there, I don't know. But I think it was instant transmission. And everybody is excited to see him, except obviously Piccolo, Vegeta, and Trunks, and, who else? Vegeta, Trunks, and Piccolo, as far as I know. I think everybody else is really excited to see him. But, yeah. Gohan obviously goes and hugs his dad. I'm surprised Chi-Chi didn't try and go get a hug in either. But, yeah, Goten gets to meet his daddy, and he's obviously happy about it after a moment, because he kind of was hiding behind his mom. And then when he finally realized that actually it's his dad, yeah, he goes and jumps into his arms. So, now he's only got 24 hours before he has to go back to Otherworld. Whether that actually happens or not remains to be seen, because a bunch of stuff happens in this tournament arc. Anyway, Videl ends up meeting up with them, and she essentially tells Gohan that she has been keeping up with her flying training, and demonstrates that she has. Oh, and while before the tournament even started, after she got her flying training, she was at the dojo training, unlike her father. And she has actually surpassed her father a lot, essentially, so I would laugh if she actually went against him in a fight and kicked his butt. I would laugh. I would be proud of her. I'd be saying, go Videl! Kick your father's butt! Anyway, they all get signed in, and, apparently, like I said, I think in the last episode, there's a junior division in this tournament now. Instead of just having the kids participate with the adults, it's all the kids participating together, and they have their own champion. I think Videl was possibly champion of her when she competed last time in the junior division. But it's for like 15 and younger, I think, because Gohan and Videl are over 15. I think they're 16. Because the whole hyperbolic time chamber kind of made that a little off. But I think he's at least 16. Anyway, obviously Goten and Trunks are not happy about this, because they want to participate with the grown-ups. Obviously, like it was back then, but obviously they're not going to get to. Anyway, they're heading to get changed, obviously, into their whatever they're going to wear. And none of them really changes their clothes, to be honest. But Goku finally realizes that Android 18 is there, and that Krillin actually has to tell him that, yeah, they're married, and they have a kid. And Goku's like, well, how do you have a kid if she's a robot? And she's not a robot, she's a cyborg, actually, not an android. An android is a human, is a robot with near-human-like intelligence. Like, dang it, what are some notable androids? Could somebody let me know, please? But yeah, they are not androids, they are cyborgs, which is a human that has been given robotic augmentations, essentially, like robot parts in their human body, essentially. That's what they are, essentially. So she's mostly human, so she has the ability to have kids. Anyway, I think that's mostly what this episode is them getting to the tournament. Anyway, I will hope you guys enjoyed this, and I gotta go deal with the kids again, and I will see you all next time.